Same. So parsing is one of the most fundamental problem in all of the compiling. So whatever compiler you are using, parsing is a fundamental thing, and everywhere you will find it. Okay, the source program has multi-character lexemes. I'm telling you numbers of time lexemes. So when you write something like this, count equal to count multiplication 60. Here this count is called as lexeme. Okay, and when it will be stored into some symbol table, and it will assign something like this, say some ID 2, then this is going to be called as token. So later again this discussion will come back, and this question also quite popular: what is difference between lexeme and token? Okay. Now, so okay, lexemes are grouped by lexical analyzer. We already know it, into token, and whose first components are terminal processed by the parser. A parser or parse tree pictorially shown how the start symbol of a grammar drives a string in the language that we have already seen in our previous one. Okay, if a non-terminal A has some production rule like this, A to XYZ, then the parse tree may have an interior node with three children labeled X, Y, and Z. So what is this? We will have a node A with three children. Childrens are what? X, Y, and Z. Okay. A parse tree pictorially shows how the start symbol. Okay, so this is what I have already shown you. So in parsing, the root of the tree is leveled by the start symbol. We already know each leaf is leveled by terminal. Okay. And or by what? Why it is given? Sometimes you are going to get the value, the terminal value from the keyboard when it is going to execute. That can happen. Okay. So that is the reason. Okay. Then each interior node leveled by a non-terminal. Okay, so if it is a node in the tree, definitely it is going to be a non-terminal. Okay, and if it is leaf, definitely that is going to be a terminal. Okay, now if A is a non-terminal leveling some interior node, and all x1 to xn are level the children of that node from left to right, then there must be a production A to x1 to xn. Here x1 to xn is stand for a symbol. We don't know why that symbols are terminals or non-terminal. So it is written that is either a terminal or non-terminal. That means each of these x, they can be terminal or they can be non-terminal. As a special case, if A to epsilon is a production, then a node labeled A may have single child level as epsilon. Now, some terminologies about the derivation tree or parse tree is here. Who can tell me what are nodes? So in the above tree, if you see how many nodes are there in the chat box, you can write. Rishabh said 4, Shubham said 4. Then how many leaves are there? Charmi answered three. Root will be one. Rishabh answer root equal to one. Root equal to definitely always in any tree there will be single root only. Otherwise it will no. Yeah, there will be single root only. So we know what is node. Nodes are basically those points in the tree which are going to be further derived. Okay. Or we call the what was the term in the previous slide? Interior node. Okay. We also call them as interior node. To specify basically, some of you have answered four, no? So if I say interior node, then it will never be confused. But usually we use the term node and interior node as similar. So we have this A as a node here, sorry, node, or you can say interior node here. This is our root also. I think root is clear to all. That is from that node. It is a special node from where our tree starts, getting we start the derivation of the tree. Okay. And if it is definitely if it is a top-down approach, then we start from the root. But in other case, if it is bottom-up approach, we will start from leaf. Okay. So thing is that only concrete thing you can write that root will always have the start symbol. Okay. Root will always have the start symbol. Then parent. What is a parent node? Which is just immediately at the upper level of your current node is called parent node. That means for X, A is a parent node. Okay. For Y, A is parent node and Z is parent node. Is what is A is these connections A to X, A to Y, A to Z. These are called as A's. Then child or descendant. If you look from top down, then X, Y, Z are children of A. Okay, or X is child of A. Okay, or you can say descendant of A. Okay, then comes ancestors. It means if it is at the upper level, that means A can be called as ancestor of X. Okay, then siblings are there. X and Y are siblings. X and Y are siblings, and X and Z are siblings. And that means which nodes are at the same level. Okay, so siblings are at same level. Okay, and leaves you already know which are at the bottom level of the tree and are. Leaves are given by what? Terminals. So if your parsing happens, correctly, successfully, then your leaves you will find all leaves are become terminal. There is no non-terminal in the leaf. Okay, and all your nodes, all your interior nodes. Are became non-terminals. Understand? Now, the similar example only notations are changed? No. The same production rule is given and drive this. So here answer is given here. What will be the answer? We all have done it just before few minutes. Okay. So you can see here. So here, I show you all these terminologies. This is your root, which is a start symbol. Okay. This list, digit, all these things are interior nodes, right? These all are interior nodes. This is also, and these are your leaves. Okay, which are again non-terminal, which are terminals. Okay, and you can see these nodes I have circled with the black are basically non-terminals. Understand. Then comes ambiguity, what this issue somebody had also raised, right? So what is ambiguous grammar? A grammar can have more than one parse tree generating for a given string of terminals. So that means, so you have a grammar G with some production rule P, and you have been given some string of terminal like say 9 minus 5 plus 2. Okay, so when you are trying to generate parse tree from this, what you are finding that it is not a one tree. You can generate multiple tree or more than one tree, which parse trees are capable to generate this. Okay, then you will say that this grammar is a ambiguous grammar. Okay, since a string with more than one parse tree usually has more than one meaning. Yes, it is. What will happen? If if you have multiple tree for this kind of arithmetic expressions, you will find that it is going to give you wrong result. Okay, when you are evaluating, because the priority are between negative sign or minus and plus are not going to be maintained. Okay, even there is, if there is brackets, and if there is multiplication and plus. So which operation need to be done first? That is not going to be maintained properly. If that is not maintained properly, I mean, there is chance of not maintaining it if you are using different tree or multiple tree are going to evaluate them in different way. Okay, so we need to design unambiguous grammars for compiling application, right? Because understand, in your compiler, if you have ambiguity or ambiguous grammars, then even if you, write some write some arithmetic expression, say something like this, it can lead you to some wrong result due to ambiguity in the grammar in the compiler. Okay, or use ambiguous grammar with additional rules to resolve the ambiguous. The ambiguities. That means, say, in some case, you have ambiguous grammar and you are in a situation that you have to use it. Right? So, in that case, you have to find out some rules, some logic that if this ambiguities arises, then how to resolve them. Okay? So, ambiguity resolving the ambiguity is another task. in such situations. Okay. Now, what is ambiguity? See, if you have this expression and I ask you to if I ask you to generate parse tree for this, in last time when I have asked you, all of you have given almost same parse tree, because okay, all of you had given similar or same similar parse tree, I should say. Okay, because you was I think assuming that okay, in either way this result is going to be same or whatever. Okay, but when yes, in that case both the parts will give same result. But if you see, if I want to mean this, that means if I put this opening bracket and closing bracket, then you know 9 minus 5 plus 2 will give something, and if I put this bracket here, it is going to give you something else, correct? So when you was writing or you was generating this traits, you had basically two options. One, you start with list, then you do list plus digit was there, then this list was done like this, list minus digit, then this list to digit, and this digit to 9, this digit to 5 you had done, this digit to 2 you had done. Okay, so this is one possible tree you can have. Another you can have, if somebody decide, no, I will not use this rule first, instead I want to use list minus digit first, then this will give me list and digit, correct? Then this list will be using third rule, I think, give us digit, and this digit can give us 9, this digit can give us 5, and this digit can give us 2. So still we have 9 plus 5 minus 2. Understand? So you can visibly see that this tree and this tree are not same. They are different, right? And you think, instead of plus sign, if you have a multiplication here, both the tree are going to give you wrong result. Both are not both the tree, either tree is going to give you wrong result. Understand? Only thing is that if you have a set of grammar and you have you have 9 minus 5 multiplication 2. Okay, so in this kind of arithmetic expression, and say that rule we had like least 2 least multiplication digit. Okay, we had plus. So plus is not there, multiplication is there, and taking this, if you try to generate parse tree, then some of you will give correct result and some of you will have wrong result. Understand? All right. So, by convention, if you have 9 plus 5 plus 2, it is equivalent to 9 plus 5 in bracket and plus 2 outside. Okay. And 9 minus 5 minus 2 is equivalent to 9 minus 5 minus 2. So, here we will not face the problem. But when an operation like 5 has operator to its left and right, like if you see here 5. If you look at 5 and its left side and right side, if you see, in this right, 5 is having here both the side plus, and here if you see, 5 is having both the side minus. Okay. Then conventions are needed to decide which operator applies to that operand. But here, this 5 is the operand. So which one? This one or this one? Which one will be applied to 5? That convention need to be defined. Okay. Now, if you see, operator plus is associated to left. So we call it as a left associated operator, because an operand with plus sign on both side of both side of it belongs to operator to its left. Okay. So in most programming languages, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division are left associated. So we know it. Okay. Now exponentials, if you think about if you think about something a to the power n, then they are always right associative. That means a to the power n is right like this, right? So they, here it is going to be a right associative. Okay. Then assignment operator equal sign. You see, and its descendants is right associative. That means if you write a equal to b, what happens? A value of b is going to be assigned to a. Okay, so we call it as right associative. And its descendant means if you write b equal to c, that means it will first assign the value of C to B and then value of B to A. Okay, so this happens in the same way as expression this. Okay, so right to letter equal to letter or writer letter, and then digit to A to B up to Z, whatever it can be. So parse tree, if we want to try. Yeah, so can you generate parse? Here it is not busy, it is going to be later. Okay, so can you generate parse tree for this and this one you have given, that is 9 minus 5 minus 2, using our this old grammar rules what I had shown, this to digit that one. Okay, and using these rules you have to generate another parse tree for a equal to b equal to c. So who can answer? I am giving you 5 minutes. What we had at least two. Just a minute. Yeah, we had a rule least two, least minus digit. Least minus digit. Then this list, again using the same rule, can give us least minus digit, then this list can give us digit, and this digit can lead us to 5. This digit, sorry, 9. This digit can lead to 5, and this can lead to 2. So we have 9 minus 5 minus 2. Okay, so this is one answer. Another thing, for A equal to B equal to, sorry, A equal to B equal to C, we can do start with, right, using this rule. It gives us, letter, then the assignment operator, then we can choose to have just a minute, we can choose to have here right. Okay, that will be good. I am going out of space, so let's clean this. Okay, so in the meantime, I think Rishabh have also sent some answer. Yeah. So, sorry. Start with right. Right is the starting symbol here. So it gives us letter, assignment operator, and right. Okay, then this letter can be ended off with A, and this right can be again, you know, evaluated with the same rule, letter equals not same rule. Right now we are going to choose letter equal to, sorry, letter equal to letter, understand, letter equal to letter. So here also we'll get letter. Now this letter can lead us to B, and this can lead us to C. So we have successfully generated a parse tree for this you know, for this given string, and using this given grammar rules. Okay, so yeah, yes, so this is what I was telling you. You use this previous production rules, which we had like list, not previous, I am just modifying it, right? So list to list plus digit, list to list multiplication, digit, and you had list to digit, and finally we had digit to 0 to 9. Now, if I ask you to draw a derivation tree for this given string, then you have two options basically. You all can generate two kind of tree. So I want you. So even clues are given here, what are the two trees possible. You draw both the tree and evaluate them and give me the answer. What answer you will get if you are going to follow this, if you are going to follow this. Then it will be clear for everyone that, you know, how ambiguity can affect your result. Are you doing this? Where is your seer? He is not looking to today. Rishabh uploaded some answer. Let me check it out. Rishabh, this is one tree. In a single place, you must you can do both the tree and you can evaluate the result and you can write in the bottom. So that in a single image, it will be clear. Then Charmi Mehta answered. Charmi, again, you have done one tree. One tree is okay. But I want to see both the tree and how, you know, what that different tree is going to give you different result.
So how would the second one be like if we start with less than less plus digit, then I'm not able to derive it.
Let me see. This is what Rishabh sent another one. Okay, so I think I should show you. Let me start with this. So here the list is our starting symbol. So let's start with. Let's start with this list. Okay. List. It can give me list plus digit. Okay. Then this, that means I have applied the first rule here. Okay, then this list can be further expanded with wrong. List multiplication and digit. Okay, so I understand what Charmi said. That is, I think, correct. This grammar rules what I have given. Yes.
So can we replace, I mean
Digit.
change, exchange the
Yes.
places? So as you have derived list and digit from the first list, I mean the root one, so can we write it as list derives to digit plus list?
No, that if it is not given in the production rule, then you can't do that. All right.
Okay, sir.
So here basically I had to give another grammar production rule. I think then only it will become a ambiguous grammar for this. Okay, that is list to
Digit plus list.
digit plus list can be given or list to basically
Yeah, list can also be helped. Correct, sir.
let me do one thing. If I give the set like this, list plus list to list multiplication list, then it will work, okay? Then
yes,
it
sir.
now it became ambiguous grammar, yes.
Yes, sir.
Actually, I had given the grammar from the previous grammar, so I didn't notice it.
Excuse me, sir.
So, yeah, tell me.
Sir, even the previous one which you showed, it was not ambiguous. If you can go back to that slide. 9 plus 5 minus 2. Sir, the ambiguous that you have tried.
This one?
It is showing 9 plus 5 minus 2.
Yeah, it is becoming 9 minus 5 plus 2, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Correct answer. I understand. So actually, yeah, that grammar was actually perfect grammar. So then now it became ambiguous. So let's see. List will give list plus list. Now we can do here one thing. Again, we can. Here we can have list multiplication list. Okay. Oh, sorry. On this side. This side. List multiplication list. Now this list can become digit. This can be digit. And this can be digit. Now this digit can become 9. We have plus here. This can become 5. Multiplication here. And here 2. Okay. So this is one thing can happen. Another thing can happen. That is, like, okay, for list I'm writing L, okay, so that I can do it in a small space. L, for digit I'll write D, okay. So first I'm choosing the second rule, L multiplication L, okay, then this side here. This L, I am applying the first rule, which gives us list plus list. Now this list can be, you know, digit. This can be digit. This can be digit. That means third rule is to digit. Then this digit can become 9. This digit can become 5, and this digit can become 2. Okay. So both the tree you can see. Giving us 9 plus 5 multiplication 2, both the tree giving this. But when you will evaluate for the first tree, if you are going to evaluate this node first, which will give you, which will give you 10 basically, 5 into 2, 10. This node answers 10. And this node will give you 9, so it is going to be 9 plus 10 equal to 19. But here if you see, this node is going to be evaluated first. It is going to give you 9 plus 5, which is 14. And this 2 is going to be here, you know, this L is going to be give you the value 2. So 14 into 2, you are going to have 28 for this tree. So understand, this is what is actually ambiguity is, okay? And this is how ambiguity can affect your result. You are writing same expression, right? Same expression you are writing, but as the parser is having ambiguity and you don't know that which tree is going to be constructed by the parser, if, you know, with the ambiguous grammar, then you know you may get some unexpected result. Okay. So yeah, a grammar for arithmetic expression can be constructed from a table shown and the associativity and precedence of operators. That, yeah, definitely right. So if we are going to develop a grammar for arithmetic expression, two things we need to keep in our mind. One is associativity and another is the precedence of the operators. So operators on the same line have the same associativity and precedence. So like, you know, left associative operators are plus and minus, left associative are also multiplication and this division, but they are having different precedence, right? This is having higher precedence. Okay, now we create two non-terminal expression and term for the two levels of precedence, and the extra non-terminal factor for generating basic unit of the expression. So the basic unit of expression are precisely presently digits and parenthesized expression. Okay, so what we do, we write a very simple and basic rule, like factor equal to either a digit or expression inside bracket. Okay, now we add some more rules to this to, you know, mature or make our grammar more functional. That is, expression can give us expression plus term, and it can give us expression minus term or only term. Now here you can see in this line we have written the rules which are having this this for plus, for minus, we have written. Both of them are left associative and equal precedence. And here we are doing term to term multiplication factor and term division factor. And you can see this multiplication and division, both of them are having same precedence and same associativity. Okay, and further, this term can lead to factor only. And we know what is factor, right? So, sorry, here. Comma should be there. This is another rule: factor to digit or expression. Okay, so if we have this set of grammar rules, then we can again evaluate this expression. 9 plus 5 multiplication 2. Okay, so Can you solve this? Can you drive a derivation tree using this production rules? So do you think this is going to lead you to ambiguity? If somebody is doing the answer in the chat box, you first write yes so that I will wait for you for a few minutes. Otherwise, I will start solving. You will always submit your answer to this form only. Okay, so it shows time. So by time, I will understand that when you have submitted. So anybody is doing it, or should I show it? Okay, then nobody is responding, so I'm showing you. So here the start symbol is EXPR. Okay, see, we have only from the start symbol we have three option. We can choose this rule, we can choose this rule, or we can simply go for term. Okay, but if you go for term, you can see that this term will not lead to any rule, which will lead to plus sign again. Okay, so we should not go with term, and there is negative sign, so we will not go with this second rule also. So we will go with the first rule, so which will give us x pair plus term. Okay, then this, see, look at this, we have x pair here, but we need a multiplication this side, right? So what we'll do here, we'll apply the third rule, x pair to term. Okay, and this term don't need to expand, so this term I will do term to factor this one. Okay, then this side, this term I can do term multiplication factor. Okay, then this term can again give me factor. Okay, this factor can give me 9, because factor to digit is there. Okay, so this factor also can give me 5, and this factor can give me 2. So you can see the derivation tree is constructed, and we have generated derivation tree for 9 plus 5 plus 5 multiplication. So what was my expression? My expression was nine plus 5 into 2, sorry. Nine plus 5 multiplication 2. So I need, okay, so we start with ex pr, which gives me ex pr plus term. Okay, this term, if I use this rule, this term gives me term multiplication factor. Okay, then this expression can be simply converted to term using this expression to term, this rule. Okay, then this term can be I can use term to factor, this rule can give me factor, and factor can be a digit, and the digit can be 9. Okay, plus this term can be factor, and this factor can be digit, which can be 5. This factor can be digit, and this digit can be 2. So we have 9 plus 5 multiplication 2. Okay, so now you can see in this grammar there is no chance of doing to have ambiguity. Okay, because it is written in such way, like instead of putting all these rules with different precedence and assertivity in a generate from a single line, it is generating from different leading symbol. You can see plus and negative sign are generating only by x pair, this variable, and it is introduced another variable term which can lead to multiplication and division. Okay, so and these are small tricks we can later use to remove ambiguity from ambiguous grammars. Okay, so syntax directed translation is done by attaching rules for program fragments to produce in a grammar. For example, consider expression expr generated by the production expr ex, you know, this one the suffix one is just to show you that this is the another appearance of expr. Okay, so expr to expr plus star. So expr is the sum of two sub expressions expr one and tar. Okay, so the superscript sorry the subscript I have already told you the subscript one or expr one is used only to distinguish the instance of expr in the production body from the head of the production, because in the head of the production we already have expr, here we have another one. So people may be confused, so just to understand or just to represent that this expr is another appearance of the same thing or another instance of the same expr, so the suffix one is given. Okay, so I think last 2 hours I'm continuously speaking, so better to take 5 minutes of break and then start. Is it okay for you?
Sure, sir.